congratulations on your new Class B motorhome and welcome to the van life. Folks, I'm Ian Baker and today we're gonna meet your new Class B. Just go over a couple different things, some different pitfalls to look out for. That way you have the best experience possible when you're out there RVing. Let's just start off on the chassis. So you kind of have like three major chassis in the Class B industry. You'll have the Ram ProMaster, the Ford Transit, or the Mercedes-Benz. The reason I bring that up is because what you'll want to do is familiarize yourself with these shops that are around you that are authorized to work on your specific chassis. It will come with a maintenance schedule and you'll want to make sure you stick to that to get the longevity out of your coach. So again, just kind of see, you know, talk to a couple different shops and see which ones you like. So that way, if you do need service, you know where to go right off the bat. And, you know, as you start to travel and you get to a destination, again, it doesn't hurt to look where you may have locations along your path or once you get there, again, just in case you do need service. Coming around to the side here, let's talk a little bit about the van door. So one of the great things about Class B vans, of course, is you have the door that opens like so, and oftentimes you will also get some sort of screen. This is a big one for me just because I really love to be able to open this up, open the back up, and have the airflow coming through. Just again, be careful when you open or close that, especially if you have dogs. Last thing in the world you want is to have them jump right on through there, so just be cognizant of that. Also, because of the sliding door, generally with your awning on a Class B, it'll be one that is horizontal like this one here. Now, for most of them, you can extend it and have it out just as it is, just using the horizontal arms. If there isn't any kind of breeze, if it starts to get windy at all, if you're down on the beach, as that wind starts to pick up, I highly recommend using the legs and attaching them to the side of the RV just for that extra structural support. So that way, again, your awning doesn't get damaged. You will see this one has the pop-up bed. Your Class B may not, but if it does, then we can take a look at that inside. Just make sure, of course, that obviously it is down and it is locked into place before you take off, because if you hit a lot of bumps, it is strut supported, and if you hit a big enough one, that can pop up if it's not locked down, so just make sure you do that. We'll get to some of the controls when we get inside, talk a little bit about solar. While we're out here, though, I do want to talk about your alternative power source. And by that, I mean the style of generator you have with your Class B. If you have, you know, what I will call your standard Cummins Onan, whether it is a gas, diesel, or LP generator, you want to make sure you run that fairly often. One of the biggest service calls we get on Class B vans, and in fact, pretty much any motorhome across the board, is on the generator, because they go to start it and it won't start. And what happens is that the carburetor ends up getting gummed up, and because you're not running any kind of fuel through there, it just gets old and then it won't start. So if you do have, again, your Cummins Onan generator, try to, you know, start that up and run it at least once a week, just so that way, you know, it's not, it has all that, the old fuel in there. And if you are gonna be done with it for the season, make sure you get it serviced. So that way, again, it will start for you on the next season. Now, if you have a little bit different system, maybe you have lithium batteries and like an underhood generator, something like that, which is essentially a souped up alternator, that's gonna be a different story altogether. So just kind of familiarize yourself with what you have. So that way you can, again, hopefully avoid some of those issues down the road. When we talk about Class Bs, oh, I'll hit this first before we open the door. This one's kind of cool, and not all of them have this either, but this is a storage system for a bike rack. Now, if you have this, great. If not, don't worry. Pretty much every Class B will have a hitch on the back, and so you're a receiver, so that way you can put, you know, a bike rack or something like that in there if you so choose. Again, depending on the chassis, a lot of Class Bs can tow somewhere between 3,500 and 5,000 pounds. So if you do need to tow a boat or a trailer or something behind you, a smaller trailer, a lot of times they can handle that as well. But just know that even if you don't have the bike rack, a lot of times you can still put one in there. You'll be just fine. Also, there's generally some kind of way to get up on the roof. You know, you do still want to get up there just to kind of check it out, make sure everything is good, make sure all your seals are good up there. You know, they will have different ladders, or they may not have a ladder at all. So if not, you know, maybe a good idea to pack one. But you know, this one happens to have a magnetic ladder, which is kind of cool. You can get up there different ways, as well as get up there and make sure your solar is clear. A lot of people don't know this, but with most solar panels, if you even have like, let's say like a small branch fell down is on top of your solar panel, it will actually greatly inhibit the amount of energy it can pull in. So you want to make sure that it is free and clear as well, you know, especially when you are at your campsite. Let's open up the door real quick. One of the things I do want to talk about is the major storage area on a Class B, because generally it will be right back here. So most Class B setups, you'll have three different types of what I call, you know, rear configurations. You'll have what we have here, which is a twin. So you have twin beds on the side, and generally that converts into a king like we have here. You'll have a sofa right here, and that one usually is power, sometimes manual, but that will drop down and create a queen bed in the back. Or the third kind will be a rear bath, right? Instead of a side aisle bath, this will be one big bathroom. And all of them have their advantages and disadvantages. None of them is necessarily better than the other. It just depends on what you want, which is probably why you bought that specific coach. But what I want to talk about is familiarizing yourself with the storage and how to access it in your Class B. Like I said, a lot of times, right back here, you know, in the back will be some of your best storage options, and it's generally very easy to access those. Especially if you have like the rear sofa configuration, usually underneath that sofa is really big storage, and so you want to be able to utilize that. Again, oftentimes back here is where you will find outside water access too. So if you need to spray off dog, wash your hands, anything like that, a lot of times you will have to open up the back door to get to that. So just bear that in mind, because I do see a lot of people that, you know, like I say, we talk about a bike rack, or I've seen like spare tire carriers, right? And they put them on here and it closes off access to that back lot, and it can just become kind of inconvenient over time. So just keep that in mind. And then on this side, it'll vary greatly on your driver's side of your different terminations, propane fill, you know, all of your water hookups. Again, it's one of those things where you just want to make sure that you are very familiar with your coach, how to dump the tanks, you know, make sure that you are dumping your black before your gray, so that way it helps wash things out, things like that, as well as where all of your hookups here are here on the outside. There's really not too much else I want to talk about here. Backup camera, you know, as you'd expect, I'll show you where that is when we go inside, but speaking of inside, let's head on in and take a look. Once inside, first thing I always tell people to do is, like any other vehicle, get yourself comfortable. You know, if you have any kind of steering wheel tilt or anything, adjust that to what you like. And then same thing with your seat. Make sure your lumbar support and everything else is good for you for the longer ride. One of the great things about a Class B, as I'm sure you know, as you've recently purchased one, is that not only are they easy to drive, because it can essentially be your everyday driver, but you'll also get great fuel economy, and that's across all chassis. You know, some are gonna be a little bit better than others, but either way, as far as motorhomes go, you definitely have some of the best fuel economy out there. So you can be very happy with that. But I always like to tell people, you know, familiarize yourself with some of the controls, both around your steering wheel, as well as in your central dash, and, you know, of course, on your panels. You know, again, some chassis will have a little bit more. If we start to get into the Mercedes chassis, for example, a lot of times you will get like adaptive cruise and collision prevention, and some other things like that. So we do just want to make sure you're familiar with how those function, as well as your center dash, because this is going to kind of be your home base when you're driving. This particular one you can see on here, you know, you have some different Bluetooth controls, telephone. One of the things I always tell people, because I know this is really important to some people, is figure out what you do have and what this unit supports. You'll see, you know, Pandora, Spotify, and Sirius XM on here. I know a lot of people really love their Sirius XM. I know some other people, you know, are big into either Android Auto or Apple CarPlay, so you want to make sure that those will function as well. That's just something, you know, that you'll want to just, again, plug it in and figure out what's working and what's not, to see what the capabilities are going to be there. Other than that, you know, one of the things that a lot of times you'll have is this right here, which is an emergency start. What that is if your chassis battery ever goes kaput on you, if it dies, then you can actually hold this and start the vehicle. And what it'll do is it will pull off your house battery. So that way you're not stuck out in the middle of nowhere with a dead chassis. So that's always something you'll want to find as well. And again, you know, the normals, adjust your mirrors, make sure everything is good to go there. With the Class B, a lot of times your seats do turn around as well, so you can utilize this as space. That's not the case in all of them, but a lot of them you will get that benefit too. And then as we kind of take a step back, I just want to hit on a couple other things. One of them is going to be TV and AC. So we talked a little bit about power. A lot of things in here, right, will run off 12 volts. You know, your lights, for example, will run off 12 volt. Your awning will run off 12 volt. But some things are going to require 120. Now, a TV, it depends on how the TV is hooked up. You may have a 12-volt TV, depending, again, on your motor coach, or it could be 120. So, you know, you'll want to check behind the TV and see what you do have so you know what you need to have to operate it. Otherwise, for things like your microwave, your AC, you are going to have 120-volt power. Now, whether that is coming from a power post or a generator, either way, it will be able to have that function. But just know that, you know, you're going to need that. Same thing with your power, for example, right here. You know, unless you have inverted outlets, which again, some coaches do. So if you have inverted outlets and this is an inverted outlet, then you'll be good. But otherwise, you will have to have your generator. You know, for example, if you want to plug in a toaster or something to that effect. Last thing I want to touch on is going to be your control panel right here. So, where'd we go? There we are. So you'll have different control panels, again, depending on your particular RV. A lot of them are going to what's called like a multiplex system like this, where everything is kind of built into one easy touchscreen panel, and you can do everything from climate control to lights, you know, generator, you know, everything you need will be right here. You can see this one has some, you know, different settings you can set up for as well, some lights rather, and then you have your, you know, different awnings, things like that, tank heaters, if you have tank heaters equipped. But just become very intimate with your controller. I recommend doing this, honestly, before your first trip. Go through all the options. Take a look at some of the settings. See what's out there. If you, for example, have a auto gen start, you're gonna wanna set that up before you get out. The last thing in the world you want is to think your auto gen set is good to go, and then, you know, you get out there and you leave for 3 days and come back and everything's just dead because your generator never kicked on because you didn't set it. So again, make sure you become familiar with that. And then, you know, you may have different water heaters as well. This one for heat has the Truma system. Not all of them do. So you are gonna, again, be familiar with that, as well as your solar controller if you have solar. This one happens to have one right down underneath the battery disconnect, but you know, again, learn about the solar that you have and the amount of power that it is bringing in. So that way you kind of get a better idea of, you know, how much light you have for your batteries to get topped off. A lot of times, you know, they do rely on almost a full day of daylight for that to happen, but you know, you may have more panels up there. You may have a bigger system. It all depends on what you purchased. When it comes to Class B, folks, you made a great purchase there. The van life is amazing. You can get out there, do some great exploration. But then, again, there are some things you're going to want to familiarize yourself with before you do get out and go. If you have questions, please don't hesitate to give us a call here at Camping World or stop on into your local Camping World to be able to ask those questions so we can walk you through, make sure that you have the best experience possible, because as we know, folks, RVing shouldn't just be fun, it should also be easy.